Hello students, today we are going to discuss about oscillation. First we can define what is periodic motion. Any motion which repeat itself after regular interval of time, it is periodic motion. Example, rotation of the earth around the sun, motion of a pendulum, vertical oscillation of a loaded spring, oscillation of a magnet suspended in a magnetic field. Now we can define what is oscillatory motion. That is a motion in which a body moves to and fro repeatedly about a fixed point. It is oscillatory motion and it repeats its motion after regular interval of time. So from the definition, it is clear that all oscillatory motion are periodic, but all periodic motion are not oscillatory. That is, oscillatory motion is precisely periodic motion plus to and fro motion about a fixed point. We can discuss this example, that is simple pendulum, and the dotted lines shows the to and fro motion of the bob. This is the equilibrium position, this is the positive maximum and this is the negative maximum. So displacement at the extreme point, it is taken as A. So negative extreme, it is minus A, and at positive extreme, it is plus A, and at equilibrium, it is zero. Now acceleration. At the extreme points, acceleration is maximum, and at equilibrium, it is zero. Now speed. It is zero at the extreme point and maximum at the equilibrium point. Now kinetic energy. This again zero at the extreme point and maximum at the equilibrium point, whereas potential energy, it is maximum at the extreme point and minimum at the equilibrium point. And oscillatory motion can be mathematically represented as sine or cosine function. We know that sine and cosine function has a period of 2 pi, so it can be expressed as sine theta plus 2 n pi is equal to sine theta. Now we can define what is simple harmonic motion. An expression containing sine or cosine function, it is harmonic function, and an oscillation which can be expressed in terms of harmonic function, it is simple harmonic motion. Two types, linear simple harmonic and angular simple harmonic. So we can define what is linear simple harmonic motion. It is defined as a linear periodic motion of a body in which the restoring force is always directed towards the equilibrium position or mean position, and its magnitude, it is directly proportional to the displacement from the equilibrium position. So look at the figure. The first figure, it is in equilibrium state. That is a mass M attached to a spring of negligible mass. Now, the mass is displaced through a distance x, and the restoring force, it is acting towards the equilibrium position. So, we can define F is proportional to minus x. So, mathematically, how can we express simple harmonic motion? That is, F is proportional to minus x. So, in the differential form, we can write it as m into d square x by d square is proportional to minus x. Changing the proportionality constant, we get m into d square x by d square equal to minus kx. Now, taking m to the right hand side, the equation will become d square x by d square equal to minus k by m x. We are putting k by m as omega square. So, equation become d square x by d square equal to minus omega square x. Rearranging the equation, we get d square x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. This is called the differential equation of motion of a linear simple harmonic oscillator. I think it is clear. Now we are going to define the expression for displacement. So we have the equation d square x by dt square plus omega square x equal to 0. To solve this differential equation, we are multiplying the equation by a factor 2 into dx by d dt. So now our equation become 2 into dx by dt into d square x by dt square plus 2 into omega square x dx by dt equal to 0. And this equation, it can be written as d by dt of dx by dt the whole square plus omega square x square equal to 0. That is, we know that the derivative of dx by dt the whole square is equal to 2 into dx by dt into d square x by dt square, and differential form of omega square x square is equal to 2 into omega square x into dx by dt equal to 0. So this equation can be written in this form, that is taking d by dt outside. Now integrating d by dt of this equation, we get d square x by dt square the whole into whole square plus omega square x square plus c equal to 0 or equal to c, where c is the constant of integration when the displacement is maximum. That is, we are considering it as a, x is equal to a. So when x is a constant value a, we get dx by dt is equal to 0. That is, velocity will become 0. Now we are substituting this condition in this equation to find the value of c. So we get c is equal to, here dx by dt is equal to 0, and here x takes the value a. So equation becomes 0 plus omega square a square equal to c. That is, omega square a square equal to c. Now we are putting this value in this equation. So we get dx by dt the whole square plus omega square x square equal to omega square a square. Rearranging, dx by dt the whole square equal to omega square into a square minus x square. So we get dx by dt equal to plus or minus omega into square root of a square minus x square. What is dx by dt? It is the velocity of the particle. So this gives the velocity of the particle which is of a linear simple harmonic oscillator. Now we get dx by dt equal to plus or minus omega square root of a square minus x square. We are taking the positive value, that is dx by dt equal to plus omega into square root of a square minus x square. Rearranging, we get dx by square root of a square minus x square equal to omega into dt. Integrating once again, we get sine inverse x by a equal to omega t plus psi, where psi is the constant of integration. So we get x by a equal to sine omega t plus phi. So we can express x as a into sine omega t plus phi. So we define the displacement x as a sine omega t plus phi. Now we have another value, minus omega into square root of a square minus x square. So rearranging this equation, we get cos inverse x by a equal to omega t plus delta. So x is equal to a cos omega t plus delta. So we get two values for x, that is a sin omega t plus phi and a cos omega t plus del. Here x is the displacement and a is the maximum value of displacement. And we can take the maximum value of displacement, that is a, as amplitude. And this omega t plus phi is the phase of the motion. So that equation gives the solution of the differential equation, which gives the displacement of the particle at any instant. And that is, x is the displacement of the particle, a is the amplitude of the particle, and omega t plus phi is called the phase of vibration at any time t. When t is equal to 0, the phase becomes phi. This is called initial phase. In the second equation, initial phase is delta. It shows that depending upon the initial position, we get different solution. And for angular simple harmonic motion, the solutions are given by theta is equal to theta 0 sine omega t plus 5 and or it is theta 0 into cos omega t plus delta. Thank you.